useful things out of that last tower cache. Well,
I can barely keep where track that came from. All.
As long as nothing happens to me. Unlikely. Understood? Get yourself to the churchyard. We'll unlock the gate so you can reach the area. Existed. Stay out in the open. If I am satisfied you are alone, you will see me.
Truly at the cruel heart of the Tower Collective, to serve as a symbol under which to unify their impressionable masses. Next, we have Mama is dead. Followed closely by she is deathly ill. Then, of course, one of my personal favorites, Mama is afraid of her people. So she hides, knowing that the tower's time as the dominant voice of Nola is drawing to a close. Its collapse imminent once the blindly obedient finally realize there is so much more for them beyond the oppressive wall. Now, I must admit, I have never laid eyes on Mama myself. My time on their side of the wall was brief as a mayfly. The tower's ways do not reward those who believe in the power of autonomous thought. But whatever you believe, there is an undeniable truth. The tower is in decline. Their philosophy, their lack of vision, and their cruelty have ensured their own doom. Has Mama seen it already? The end? Surely someone of her acumen can right the ship, set the tower back on a benevolent course. And yet it appears that Mama has abandoned her flock. Why has she chosen to withdraw when the tower is so desperately in need of strong leadership? Isn't it obvious, New Orleans? Mama knows she's
I know Omri is dead, and I know that for the time being you stepped into his shoes, whoever you are. I am not in the habit of trusting people these days. Trust gets you dead when it's given to the wrong person, and there is a lot of wrong out there. But I am willing to set prejudice aside for a few moments so we can have a little chat, see if we can work together. I'm assuming you scored a few useful things out of that last tower cache. Well, I know where that came from. As long as nothing happens to me. Understood? Get yourself to the churchyard. I will unlock the gate so you can reach the area. Stay out in the open. If I am satisfied you are alone, you will see me.
That's got to do with the other side of this area.
Don't get used to meeting like this. It's a rarity.
Bloody itch on minerals.
I'm not fond of the face-to-face either. Too much work.
All right, then we're on the same page. I'll get to the point. Why are you helping me?
Seems like your heart is in the right place. Can't say that for most.
Maybe we'll get along after all. Regardless, seems like we can help each other. I'll point you to tower caches with useful supplies, and you get me the intel they contain. Sound like a deal?
Maybe. But I have a question first. The tower seems to be after you and your daughter hardcore. What's that all about?
You spotted those posters, huh? You wanna go there? All right, I'll give you the basics. I used to be with the tower. Now I'm not. We don't see eye to eye. I'm in the right, they are in the wrong. That's all I got for you now.
This time, yeah. Can't make any promises long term, though.
Fair enough. No promises from me either. Take this drawing. There's some intel at the location in the drawing. When you have it, leave it for me at the usual spot.
Consider it done.
Thank you.
chocolate canache. Good fish.
never know when you're gonna need a shotgun. Upgraded with 9 small slots. Yep. Right. 4 pages of shit. Kind of pissed. Right now I'll start building towards that. Medicine. But this stuff ain't that bad. I mean, I can already make a knife, I can make a revolver, and the ammo. Yes, I'm blaming the both of them, the Stumpy and the Dave. No, it doesn't matter how hard you try, they always manage to get the hair everywhere. I've got nothing to do in the old town at the moment, I'm going to Memorial Lane. Go kick some zombie butt and probably get shot at and killed again. Well, I don't need rifle frames at the moment. No! stabby left. Should have probably checked the durability on that screwdriver. Hostile, or you can be friendly.
No one gets inside. Strict orders. You have a problem with that? See Jeff. He's around the corner.
Yes, but which corner?
Anthony, how could he be so dense? He should have known better.
What was he thinking? These are people who have chosen.
You got nerve rolling in here uninvited.
Don't mean to intrude.
We don't need strays poking around right now. We have enough problems to deal with.
I prefer to think of myself as a free agent, open to all opportunities.
You know what? Yeah, you might prove useful. My brother is in some deep shit. Pack of reclaimed scum snatched him. Anthony's a good kid. Bit dim, but he doesn't deserve whatever those freaks have in store. We can't get anywhere near where they're holed up. Light Blue House across the way. They'll gut him immediately if they see us coming. But you? They don't know you. You'll be able to stroll right in. After that, whatever you need to do, that's your business. Personally, I'd put a few bullets through their skulls. Let the dirt reclaim them.
I like to know what I'm up against ahead of time. What are their numbers exactly?
We've seen as many as 4 on the second floor. But you never know. They multiply like rats.
Sounds like I can be of service.
Get to it then. Knowing how those savages operate, he might not have much time before they execute him.
Anthony, how could he be so dense? He should have known better.
Walk away and we won't have a problem.
I could just slap you across the face.
Find somewhere else to be.
Spoon. Spoon. Ooh, you want to get some nuts from a dog bowl? You know it's got no nuts in it. Pardon me. Pretty sure that's not intentional. Hmm. bloody knows. The volume all right. Can you not hear it? The volume all right. But I don't have it turned up very loud. Very intentional. In case you get feedback. Yes, very adorable cat sandwich. Right on the hot water bottle. It's a favourite place in the whole wide world.
There's also something come up against the hot water bottle on my makeup.
Oh, yeah. I have to get the lint roller on this. You bloody captain, you bloody hair. You're adorable. I don't know how that element gets so much hair on it.
Floats in the air, doesn't it?
The teddy ain't that bad.
Top of the place. On the chair.
Tricking, because if you put something in front of the light sensor where your face goes, it turns the headset on. I'm not sure I'm about to keep itching my face so much.
Who the hell are you? The negotiator? A big tough Jeff, too chicken shit to show his face and beg for his little brother's life? Not sure I really see the point.
I guess I'm here to negotiate a deal for Anthony's release.
Release? That's some kind of joke? That motherfucker isn't going anywhere but in the dirt, where maggots belong.
What did he do?
This subhuman shit is a murderer. My daughter is dead. The tower is at fault, and he is at fault. The tower preaches community, and yet they toss out those most in need because they are no longer useful, because they are a burden. Violet was not a burden. She was a human being, but this fucker treated her like trash. He could have disobeyed orders, but he did not. He forced her out. Left her to die. She was 11 years old. Where is your head at, stranger? Exterminate this tower fuck right now, and we won't have a problem. Then we can pay the rest of the vermin a visit. And once they are a pile of corpses, whatever is in their camp, it's yours. Consider it a gift from the Reclaimed.
That sounds good to me.
We did what we had to do, right? One less brain-dead tower slug plaguing the world. Fuck it. I think it's time to put some pressure on these fuckers. We're outnumbered, but we have momentum, right? Yeah! The time is right fucking now! You with us?
No time like the present.
That's the attitude. We've got this. Let's send the message that the future belongs to the Reclaimed.
Yeah, we're the real OGs now.
These things just keep...
I said the gunfighting in this is a bit unfair.
No one gets inside. Strict orders. You have a problem with that? See Jeff. He's around the corner.
Wouldn't give her a freaking crosshair. Right.
Final warning, asshole!
But the first bloody shot went straight through, the second one didn't even do nothing.
No one gets inside. Strict orders. You have a problem with that? See Jeff. He's around the corner.
Anthony, how could he be so dense? He should have known better.
You got nerve rolling in here uninvited.
Why is it when you kill them, they drop the handgun, but it's always pretty broken. Broken when they're using it to shoot me.
beside himself. Those reclaimed shits camped across the street nabbed his dumbass brother.
To reload this is gonna break in the next shot. Let's assassinate them one by one. I didn't even know I was there when I killed himself. Bullshit. So there's one upstairs. Stay outside, one upstairs. Three outside, one upstairs.
What was he? he thinking? These are people who have chosen to be-
You got nerve rolling in here, uninvited.
Are you the negotiator? A big tough Jeff, too chicken shit to show his face and beg for his little brother's life. Not sure I really see the point.
Looks like I just walked in on something that's none of my business.
I smell bullshit. It's unwise to wonder where you don't belong, and you don't strike me as a fool. But hey, I'm willing to play along. We could use some entertainment around here. We are about to execute this filth. Want to know why?
Enlighten me.
This subhuman shit is a murderer. My daughter is dead. The tower is at fault, and he is at fault. Whoa. The tower preaches community, and yet they toss out those most in need because they are no longer useful. Because they are a burden. Violet was not a burden. She was a human being. But this fucker treated her like trash. He could have disobeyed orders, but he did not. He forced her out, left her to die. She was 11 years old. Where is your head at, stranger? Exterminate this tower fuck right now, and we won't have a problem. Then we can pay the rest of the vermin a visit. And once they are a pile of corpses, whatever is in their camp, it's yours. Consider it a gift from the Reclaimed.
He deserves to die, and I will gladly do it.
I tried to make things right. I tried. I am sorry. Please!
Put a bullet through that door! We did what we had to do, right? One less brain-dead tower slug plaguing the world. Fuck it! I think it's time to put some pressure on these fuckers. We're outnumbered, but we have momentum, right? Yeah! The time is right fucking now! You with us?
No time like the present.
That's the attitude. We've got this. Let's send the message that the future belongs to the Reclaimed.
Yeah,
These things just keep coming!
I've already killed the turrets.
Time for the tower to fall! I'll just leave you to the walkers. I'm gonna knock your sense into your skull.
That I just feel kind of empty. I guess I thought I'd feel different, fulfilled.
Hey, big brother. There's not much to say beyond I'm sorry, but I have to do this. I can't sleep. I can't eat. I'm a wreck, Jeff. I keep seeing that little girl's face. These visions of her turning. This whole mess is fucking in my head. What did the Martins do to deserve being exiled? It makes no sense. They are good people. Now, I know this might put you in a tough spot. Please forgive me, but I need to make things right. At least give them a slim chance to survive out there. I swiped some supplies from our camp, so you know who to blame. Don't want any other innocent people taking heat. I'm going out to find the Martins and deliver the stuff. Least I can do. I pray it'll help me get my head straight. If I'm not back before the bells, wish me luck. Your little bro, Anthony.
Thank you.
Time to go. Here they come. Just over here. Right there. There's my raft. Fine, gotta worry about getting diddied. Better luck next time. What's this? Hold on, let's see where I am. There we are.
forward.
Everything I need to go zombie bashing, huh? I think I gotta do is get some practice in with this bloody bow and arrow. Not bad. Did much better than that.
We cannot be afraid to ignite our passions, even in the midst of the nightmare.
Thank you.
You there, Casey? Come in.
Yeah, I'm here. Wow, you're back. Did you get it?
You're surprised? You didn't think I was gonna come through, did you? Well, guess what? I did.
I didn't know. It's insane out there. All kinds of shit could have gone wrong. But hey, this is great. Finally, some progress. It's a relief. Okay, let me find the manual for that thing, and we can get it calibrated.
You're stalling, Casey. I want to hear what you got on the reserve. Not doing anything until you hold up your end. We clear?
Yes. All clear. Okay, the reserve is real, but you already knew that, right? What you don't know is that I am in it. It's an old military bunker built in the 50s or 60s. Right after the flood, the National Guard used it as a staging area to distribute disaster relief supplies. But once the dead started walking and things really went to shit, I had no choice but to get inside and hunker down. I thought I was safe for a little while, but now I'm fucked. The flood water up top was too much for the reserve's pump system. It malfunctioned, and now the whole place is on lockdown. I'm stuck in the comm room. I'm running out of time. I need to get out of here, soon. God, I can't wait to see the sky again.
I've been working with someone named May. She claims to have a key to the reserve. You know anything about this?
If your May is May Benoit, then yeah, I've heard of her. Tower is always tossing her name around on the airwaves. They're really after her ass. Consider her a major threat. I don't know anything about a key to the reserve, though. I'll do some research. If I discover anything, I'll let you know.
You were the only one to make it inside?
Well, no. There were others, but they didn't stay. They had to leave.
If the bunker was safe, why did they leave?
Like I said, they left. They had to take care of something, okay? Nothing else to say about it.
Rumors are all over the place. What exactly is inside the reserve?
Most of the rumors are true. Food, meds, tons of it. I mean, the entire hall was meant to help tens of thousands of people in the area after the flood. And there's a bunch of guns, ammo, and gear for the troops that were meant to distribute it. All military-grade, perfect condition. Problem is, I can't get to any of it. The whole bunker is locked down because of the floodwaters.
What's the rush to get out of there?
Starvation, for one. I might have a couple weeks left of scraps down here. But none of that is gonna matter if the floodwater sitting on top of this place breaks through. The comm room is filling up slowly right now, but it's only a matter of time before the ceiling collapses. Starvation, crushed, or drowned. Pick your poison, right?
If you get crushed, at least it would be quick, right?
Yeah, well, with your help, I'm hoping to avoid all of it. Fuck, I'd rather take my chances on the surface with 100 walkers coming at me. At least I'd have a fighting chance. Look, tourist, I'm not asking you to do this out of the kindness of your heart. I mean, there's clearly something in it for you, big time. If the pumps get repaired, not only will I get out, but the supply rooms will all open up. All those disaster relief supplies, untouched. Not to mention enough weaponry and gear to arm multiple platoons. All for you to do with as you please. And for me, a fresh start and some fresh fucking air.
Why do you need me to get you out? Plenty of people are looking for the reserve. Why not get one of these groups to help you?
Well, my gut tells me that you're my best bet. The Tower and the Reclaimed are both after the reserve, sure. Obsessed with it, you might say. They believe it will shift all the power in Nola. But I don't trust them. They're too absorbed by their agendas. You're unaligned. On your own. Like me. And hey, we may as well help each other. Right?
I'm willing to take the risk.
Oh, fantastic. You won't regret it. Well, it's been a long night, but I'm too wired to sleep. I'm gonna turn this place upside down until I find the manual. You should get some rest, though. I'll contact you in the morning. Good night, tourist.
flickers in the mind's eye when you hear the word. I would wager that most of you visualize the dead that now walk among us. Those vacant eyes, clouded over. Those devouring mouths, always sad. And the smell, yeah, that probably comes to mind too. Rot.
Just turn the tap this time. Just press the power button. Because you probably knocked the charging wire. And made the screen come on. Technology, yeah. It's a bit daft that when you go to sleep, it doesn't restore your stamina. You think at the very least it would restore it by a bit. Tower crash, probably have to drink that. If I can't find anything decent. It's gonna be on the other side of this building.
Just another lost soul.
Okay.
Hey, beat it!
So that's definitely it then. Diseased. I don't know a tutorial about diseased walkers. It's a bit crafty. It's for you.
Nothing better to do?
I suggest you get lost.
still gonna be around the other side of the building, according to this, but I don't know.
I suggest you get lost.
I suggest you shut up before I put a bullet between your eyes.
Find somewhere else to be.
Suppose I could wait. Safe to get overrun by the Walking Dead.
Doesn't look so tough.
Well, I know this much. I ain't gonna be able to kill them in a fight. Way too many of them. Ooh, and an angel. Put it up there, I got it in there, you can move in. I don't know why I'm collecting them, I'm just... I might get something good, you never know. I'm not watching you at the moment.
Think it's wise to be wandering around?
Who are you and what are you doing here? Try me.
Don't hang around too long.
Should really think about heading out. So,
That's the tourist? Doesn't look so tough.
Walk around!
That's the tourist?
Feeding the fat piggy.
There is
Yeah, glad to hear your voice. Ready to get started?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Okay, good. So, I found the manual for the pump flow regulator. It looks like we need to calibrate it before it can be installed.
I'm gonna sit down.
Each of the pumps has different flow requirements, and that component tells the rest of the system where to route the water.
We should be able to figure this out.
I like that attitude. Okay, on the device, you should see a serial number. Read it to me.
Four seven three zero five eight nine dash 01.
Okay, now turn the dial until you get some feedback on valve A. Then tell me the number you see.
Feedback triggered on 55. The numbers turn green.
Okay, good. 55. According to the manual, valve B should be tuned to 28 degrees.
Valve B to 28. Got it. All numbers are green.
Perfect. Okay, last valve. One second. There we go. Valve C should be set to 67.
Valve C set. All numbers green.
Awesome. Okay, almost there. Now it says, depress the automatic confirmation mechanism. Looking at the diagram here, it's a big round button. Should be obvious.
All right. Big round button pressed.
Yes! Okay, we're calibrated. Now you need to install this sucker into the pump. The pump, it's located outside of St. Vincent's Church. Beacon lights will be on to help find it, so that's good. Of course, it'll probably attract walkers, so that sucks. Just be ready. The systems down here will let me know. When you've installed the regulator. Oh, and one more thing. A little tip that should make life a bit easier in scavenging more... fruitful since, you know, we're colleagues now, right? The tower has a radio station, number 47, that broadcasts any significant discoveries in the city and the current schedule for stirring the herd. Might be wise to tune in before heading out for the day. Privileged intel, so, you know, let's keep it between us. All right, gonna take a few moments to clear my head. I'll contact you when it's time for the next step. Good luck, and thanks.
Cannot be afraid to ignite our passions, even in the midst of the nightmare. No. It is precisely then, when the nightmare's claws are digging into the thin flesh of our fading hope, that we... Thank you.
If it keeps on raining, Levy's gone to grave. If it keeps on raining, Levy's gone to grave. The water come in, I have no place to stay. All last night, I sat on the levee and moaned. All last night, I sat on the levee and moaned. Thinking about my baby and my happy home. Oh, if it keeps on raining, levee's gonna rain. Oh, if it keeps on raining, levee's gonna break. And all these people have no place to stay. Now look here, mama, what am I to do? Now look here, mama, what am I to do? I ain't got nobody to sell my troubles to. I work on the levee, mama, both day and night. I work on the levee, mama, both day and night. I wish on the levee, mama, night and day.
I'll do one more scavenging run.
Nothing.
sharp objects.
I'm hungry and willing to kill. Give me the food. Now!
Start carrying the crowbar. If I can find one. Power of Christ compels thee. Thank you. fish tank. Well, that was unexpected. That didn't exactly work out how I thought it was gonna, but it worked. Water. Is what I need. bags are full. Which means it's time to go. Grand distractions.
Precisely then, when the nightmare's claws are digging into the thin flesh of our fading hope, that we must defy the nightmare and live. Truly live. And make no mistake, mere survival is not living. Scrounging for crumbs like a timid field mouse, begging some simpleton who bumbled away into the role of heartless dictator for guidance. Not me. I choose to embrace everything that makes me human. I choose to carve my own way through this new world. I am not a lonely animal. I should not be acting like one. Humor me for a moment while I'm counting on bows. Many of you listening will no doubt recall the campfire tale of Charlie Boy, who met his end at the hands of the Super Yonk at the Mocachita Swamp. But a lesson known Charlie Boy tale is what I will give you now. As a youth, Charlie Boy was not one to adhere to rules. In fact, you could say the young lad was a bit of a miscreant. Thieving, vandalizing, terrorizing. Mischief was in his blood. And mischief is what made the man. on a sweltering summer's eve. One of those Nola nights when the air was so thick and hot a dragonfly could barely get airborne. Charlie Boy set out from his home in the 17th Ward and stalked on over to the Garden District with revenge thumping his chest. His family had been wronged by some rich folk landlord types who were scheming to get Charlie Boy and his family evicted for no good reason at all. Now, Charlie Boy knew there wasn't much he could do being just a 12-year-old beanpole, but he was not about to sit idly by and let old money greed ruin his family without landing a counterpunch. So out of chicken wire, Charlie Boy molded a huge head and put an old Pulcinella mask on it, the nose stretching down to the chin. He painted the whole thing black as night. With the head on his shoulders, Charlie...
Sayonara.